Hi, my name is Deb. I'm a physiotherapist for Mental Health Life, and this is the 1:15 PM segment and a full set amount of time. So today we're talking about lateral ankle sprain, which is usually caused by an accident of twisting or turning the ankle in the wrong way. The ankle is a really complex joint, and its ability to go up and down, in and out, and rotate means it's complex, but it gets most of its stability from the structural arrangement of the bones and ligaments that join bone to bone. So sprain usually occurs when one of the ligaments is overstretched and it can become torn or even ruptured. And it's usually caused by a traumatic incident, such as a sudden change of direction, sport, or falling off a step or off the curve, or off the edge of the curve. Following an ankle sprain, it's really common to get a lot of bruising and bruising track down the toes. Don't be alarmed, that's normal, but you want to try and manage it as well. So there are a lot of things that you can do to help manage issues after an ankle sprain. Firstly, you want to follow RICE, which is rest, ice, compression, and elevation. Rest, particularly in the first couple of days, you want to not be walking on the ankle too much. You can do some walking, but not too much. You just don't want to aggravate all the injury too much. You may even need some crutches in the first couple of days. Inflammation is a normal response to an injury, but you really want to try and minimize the swelling. And you can do that with ice. You get ice rather than damp cloth, put it on the injured area, and no longer than 20 minutes. And just make sure that you check the skin so you're not going to get any ice. In terms of compression, you want to apply some cheek grip or an ankle support. That also helps reduce the swelling in the initial phase and also provides some stability to the joint, which, where the ligaments are weakened, stability. And you want to try and have the elevate the ankle, put your foot up above the hip height. It's a good technique to manage the symptoms of swelling. Medication can also help, and although you don't want to use it for too long, in the first few days to a week, probably for most, some oral non-steroidal anti-inflammatory painkillers and cognitive. So the first few days, it becomes really important to you. After the first few days, it becomes important to stretch your ankle just to prevent any long-term stiffness. And the gradual addition of strength and balance exercises will help regain stability around the joint. It will also help reduce the likelihood of any subsequent injuries occurring later on. So strengthening around the ankle, the hip and the knee as well is useful after the first few days and after. So there's quite a lot you can do to try and help yourself after you've had an ankle injury. That's all from me today. Thanks for listening.